So it says wavy.
There we go. Oops, I think it started a new one.
Yeah, because it's still doing this.
Oh yeah, start a new one.
Okay, hey, probably have to tell everyone to get on to the...
Had to start a new one, go back.
Yeah, okay. Okay, people are hopping on. Perfect. Okay, yeah. Let's wait a minute here. Yeah. Okay. Looks like we're...
Okay.
Cool. Looks like we're good. So we'll let people... Let's give people a second to swap over.
Are you able to change the date on there?
Yes.
While we're getting set up.
Today's the 3rd, yeah. All right, so yeah, we're...
That's a horrible one.
Okay, cool. So, yep, okay, looks like we're all set. Can you see if people are on the other one still?
Yeah, they're...
They're probably waiting on me. Yeah. That's the link we sent out. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so...
Alright, Sam, we're... That's a horrible one.
See, it's behind. It's a... Yeah. Alright, guys. Hey, what is up? So sorry about that. The live button to click to go live was missing, so...
Glued it back in.
Yep, we
ready to go.
Glued it back in. We are back. We have Kid Locke with us again.
It's awesome to be here.
Nice beanie.
Yeah.
Nice beanie. And shirt.
Swag.
Yes.
Swag. Lock Bosch swag.
Yes. What? Oop. All right. So, Tanner, you're on call right now.
I'm on call. So it's live.
It's live, right? Yeah. And so essentially is what we're doing here today is Tanner, you know, is a locksmith. He works 24 hours a day sometimes.
Yeah.
Today is one of those days. And so I told him, I was like, hey, if you get a live call, you have to answer it on live.
I'll do it. I'll do it in some country like voice or something. I'll do some.
Yeah.
Some hick.
Right?
Shouldn't say that. Yeah, something weird.
You know, just something to, you know, and we, you know, we'll be able to see some live Kid Locke.
Yeah, and don't be just calling me just to call me, like, I don't want
anyone who might be seeing this and knows the number.
Start blowing me up. Hey, man, I got a key stuck.
Yeah,
they're at a house key stuck in my BMW ignition.
Or they're locked out of their spaceship.
Right. And my Cessna, I can't get out.
Yeah. Awesome. Nice. So this past week, first of all, thank you everyone for tuning in. Let's see who we got going on here. Look at that. William C., Gustavo, Bert Simpson, Access Locks, Mr. Maintenance Man, Keith. How's it going? Now, before we get going too far, though, Tanner, it'd be rude to not offer you a Topo Chico.
I'll take one. Yeah.
A nice ice cold one?
Yeah, ice cold. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Room temperature. I'll take it. Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Good man. All right. So we got here Steve Schmidt. How's it going? Brian, Nicole. Guys, so while we get warmed up here, let's make sure any questions you have for Tanner, feel free to shoot them his way. And we're going to get him to be answering all of your questions. I'm hoping they're going to give you some tough ones today.
Yeah.
Tough ones.
Yeah.
Now, let's kind of deep dive, guys. So here, first of all, if I didn't say it, because I got a little messed up as we got going here, is welcome to the November 3rd Lock Boss Live giveaway. So we're going to announce the 5 winners here in just a little bit. But before we do, let's kind of go over the past videos this week. And Tanner, you know, we did an auto pro pad video. You know, that's something a lot of guys, you know, I was doing some the odd tech, as doing smart pro, but they're wanting to see some auto pro pad videos. So
the auto pro pad,
doing a little bit of that. Cool. And then we did the two reasons why your key is stuck. And then we did the knifing video, which actually came out of a live, right? Everyone was kind of asking about how you were impressioning keys on the last locksmith Q&A.
Yeah.
And so we did that.
Great feedback on that, too. Great feedback. You know, we just touched on just the knifing. We didn't touch on smoking the blade, smoking the key. And there we are.
And there we are, guys. Okay, here we go.
Unfortunately, this is just the other shop.
Okay. Okay, well, false alarm. Is that a false alarm?
Country Lock and Key, this is Tanner. How may I assist you?
Let's see. Uh-oh, someone's locked out of the car, it sounds like.
72 Porsche. Yeah, I can get right out there and get it unlocked for you.
Sounds like my dad.
You're looking around $75. I'm going to be there in about 20-25 minutes.
Oh, man. Topo Chico. Hey, Suncoast Picker, Rook Knight. Steam Gadget. Okay, Brittany Olson. Guys, thanks everyone for tuning in. I think I saw Mark Call on here. Hey, Mark. And Ken Nixon. How are you? Oh, yeah, Country Long Keys on there. So who was that?
That was my coworker.
Was it?
Yeah, the big coworker.
Oh, really? Yeah. So he's obviously watching.
He's watching.
And he had to call.
Hi, Pete.
Awesome. Now, let's talk about the knifing for a minute. Okay, so, I mean, I saw you were reading a bunch of the comments and kind of going over it.
Yeah.
Talk to me about what you saw in the comments and some of the other techniques that you were kind of talking about.
A lot of different techniques. A lot of guys say that, you know, they'll go on pressure the key. And we didn't go over the aspect of, I usually don't give them the knifed key. I usually will put it in the duplicator, cut them a fresh key that hasn't been twisted on and looks like it's been filed on. We never went over the smoking technique. Smoking technique works great. And then also the Sharpie, the black marker works great as well. There was a lot of different comments in there. Mm-hmm. I forget a lot of them, but man, a lot of guys have a lot of good points on how to do it. There's all different kinds of techniques and it's whatever works best for you. Whatever works best. You know?
Yeah, right. I mean, I think the knifing is a great technique, but like, you know, as I kind of talked about, I've only done it when I like try once or twice and I couldn't get it. Mm-hmm. Then I kind of go to knifing, but mm-hmm. you know, the smoking the key, Sharpies.
Yeah,
Sharpies are a good one.
And prepping your key, it just depends on how much time you have. If you have time to prep your key and give it your spacing, then you automatically know where your spacing is. Those are great points, great tips of, you know, where everybody else can see those comments also, and also get an idea of, hey, give myself some spacing. If you know it's going to be a 5-cut key, you know, cut zeros in there, or cut ones in there, mm-hmm. and start off that way. Great ideas.
Yes. Now, I want to bring up a question, okay? A real life question here.
Okay.
What do you do when you're, let's say you have some sort of a, maybe it's a motorcycle, maybe it's a filing cabinet, and you're not sure what key it is, so you try a bunch, and you're not sure if it's long enough.
Yeah.
Have you ever ran into that where you put it in, you're like, okay, this goes in, but I just feel like it might be longer, or maybe, like, I know for me, I've been trying to impression it sometimes, and I can't get it, and I'm like, man, is the key not long enough? You know, talk us through that.
Yeah, we're running that a lot, especially in the shops. We don't do, you know, a lot of auto or motorcycles out in the field, but motorcycles, they're running those HD, what are the 109s, the long bladed, long from the shoulder. Basically, I'll stick a pick or whatever I have, I'll try to stick it in the ignition or whatever lock I have, and I'll run it all the way till it bottoms out. And then I'll kind of measure it. I don't get a tape measure, but I'll kind of measure how long I'm thinking the blade has to be. And then I'll kind of get in there, you know, use a flashlight or use a tension wrench to open up the shutter if it has a shutter on it, dust cover, and see if there is a shoulder stop that you can see, you know, visible. And then you can kind of go off the length of whatever you stick, you know, if you got a long Allen wrench, whatever you can stick all the way down in the keyway to bottom it out and get your length of your key.
Okay.
That's what I do. It works. I'm sure we're going to get a lot of comments and different techniques of how to figure out if your key is long enough, if you can't take the lock apart. You know, putting your pick in there and raking to count the wafers kind of gives you an idea. But a lot of those, you know, aftermarket motorcycles are coming from overseas, running some weird key blanks, you know, long key blanks. And, you know, you don't know where your shoulder needs to be, how long your blade needs to be. Gosh, I wish I had a good answer of how to do it.
Okay.
Possibly you do, maybe?
No, I mean, I think truly the best way to do it is to get in there with a pick, like a hook pick.
Yeah.
Very slowly and try to see if you can't count those wafers.
Yeah.
Feel those here or feel those clicks.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I know I've been stuck with ignitions, like the imported scooter type things where, you know, and then like you finally figure out what the right key is, and that sucker is long, right? Long, you're just like,
yeah.
What is this, a 12 cut key?
Reminds me like the RA4 for the what is it, the Rav or the Discovery Land Rovers, that long key.
Yep.
And you never know. And those aftermarket Chinese scooters, those kick our butts every time because every single one that comes in is running a different key blank.
Yeah. Yeah, so now let's talk about pin tumblers for a minute, right?
Okay.
So we did a wafer.
Yeah.
Talk about pin tumblers, like some of the comments were like, hey, can you do a Schlage or a Kwikset key like that?
I think your tolerances are so tight, you don't have much jiggle in the keyway. And as far as tolerance goes, I don't think you're going to have enough up and down rocking motion. I mean, I'm sure there's guys out there that do it. Mailbox locks, most of them are pinned. We do a lot of mailboxes. If you want to make an existing key for a mailbox instead of just popping the door open or picking it and replacing the lock, sometimes people can't replace the lock. Sometimes they're renting and lost the key and they don't get their deposit back until they return that mailbox key, and so you're making an existing key. But yeah, pin tumblers, I'm trying to think of another lock. On file cabinets, a lot of file cabinets are running the pin locks. I usually impression all of them. Yeah, there's a key code on it. I can run out in the van, run across the parking lot, cut a key by code, come back in, or I just take 5 minutes and impression it. Pin tumblers, I think my knifing technique works great on pin tumblers too. But some guys were commenting where they like the nice flat surface where they have more to look at as far as getting a mark on your blade.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think they also talked about, you know, so you're essentially knifing it like this.
Yeah.
Is how it ends up playing out, right? Mm-hmm. And obviously the further you go down on the key, it's gonna kind of flatten out and kind of get back to it.
Back to your normal grip.
Right. I mean, would you agree though that most of the battle with impressioning is making sure your spacing's right?
Absolutely.
Right, like you know where the marks actually are.
Absolutely. Filing on a mark that was just a mark from something, who knows what.
Yes.
Had a tech go out yesterday, made a key for a 97 Subaru X123. It was his first time ever impression in one of them. And
okay.
He got it really quick, but it, you know, some of those Subarus are deep, deep fours where you're down into the keyway. And I think it right off the shoulder, I think it was a 3 or 4 depth. And he's like, no way. He's just turning that blade into just a toothpick. Turned out he did it right. Went over to the driver's door, tried it, worked great. Popped in the ignition, worked great. Went back in his van, duplicated the key. But he said that key was just down to nothing. But most Subarus are.
Yeah. Yep. Now, guys, I see, yeah, it looks like it says we kind of lost a few viewers from everyone from switching over.
Wow.
Sorry, guys. You know, here we were on such a good roll with not messing it up.
Yeah,
but
I got my swag on it.
I know, man. But guys, so I guess to answer the question with Kwikset and Schlags, like, is it possible to impression them? Yes, but this is the deal. Like on a Schlag, a 0 through 9 depth, that's a lot of filing.
That's a lot of filing,
right? And especially if you're not. If you don't pay close attention to the root of the cut you have going on, and it's like this big like ocean wave looking, it's gonna start getting wonky on you. So,
right.
I don't know. I think it's possible.
Definitely possible.
Is it something that you think you should probably do all the time? It's probably not the right option for most people.
Right. Yeah. Just
trying to pick Medico, right? Now, guys, before I go any further, I want to make sure you guys know that this Thursday, we're doing another Locksmith Q&A live panel. So get your questions, bring them to us next Thursday at 5:10, and we're going to have a good time doing it. So, Tanner, impressioning, first of all, a lot of guys are saying thank you to you.
Hey. You're welcome.
So, for doing that.
It's one thing I'm good at is impressioning.
That's the only thing?
That's...
Well, come on now. Hey, you weren't named Kid Locke.
True.
Because you're only good at impression.
I am asking for a new nickname, though, if anybody has any. Getting old kid just doesn't work anymore.
Really? Like, yeah. I mean.
Yeah. Like Grump Locksmith or something.
Just Grump
something,
Lock?
Something like that. Grump Lock?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, Tom Kaysen is asking, what file do you recommend? Like, what's your go-to file?
The finest one possible.
Finest one possible.
Number two, I believe.
Yeah.
Number two or four. Four is kind of our standard. I think that's what we usually have at the shops is fours.
Okay.
Super, super fine. I don't want any scratches. I don't want a rough file. Super, super fine file. And I use that same file time and time again. I've impressioned thousands of keys with it, and I still love that file. Yeah, the finer the better. You don't want to rasp. You don't want to rasp the key. It's not rasping. It's impressioning, right? You don't want to...
That's a good point. Or, like, my tendency is to go back and forth.
You can, it's whatever you want to do.
I mean, if you've ever seen a guy who's filed a, like, sharpened a chainsaw, and he sees you do that on a key, you know, he's like, whoa, 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 whoa. You just ruined everything.
Yeah. That is not going to cut butter.
Yes. Now, have you ever... Now, some guys in here, Ken Nixon, where did I see some more? VSP036, thanks for tuning in. They've talked about, like, they'll use the 1200 and they'll kind of, you know, impression using the 1200. Have you done you done much of that?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Great. Yeah. You get a mark, go back there and take it down to the next depth. That's a great way to do it. I mean, you're really doing precise. Your spacing is right on. That's a great, great way to do it. If you have time, just jumping back and forth. And if you have time, that's a great way to do it.
Yeah. Absolutely. I think a lot of times... If you know what you're actually doing, I think it's a great option.
Yeah.
But sometimes, you know, like you'll grab maybe a Y52 or, you know, a Y13 or a B1 and you put it in and you're like, well, this B1, like, what exactly is it or what could it be? And I think that's kind of the challenge, which brings me to one last question about impressioning. Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
Plastic ignitions. I want to go to boats. I don't want to go to plastic ignitions. If there's one thing I have seen more than anything with impressioning is broken plastic boat ignitions.
Split right now.
So if now I didn't prep you for this question, so I'm kind of putting you on the spot, but like what's two or three things when a guy has to go out and make keys for a boat or in particular or goes up to it, it's a plastic ignition. I don't know, maybe snowmobiles have plastic ignitions coming up here in the winter.
Yeah, probably think so, yeah.
Something like that. What are one or two things that they can make sure they do so they don't have one of those like, well, it kind of turns.
Oh, man. Yeah, that is a tough one. That's real, it's time consuming. You just got to go way slower, I believe. Less tension. Less rocking. It's just there's a finesse about it. You know, step one with boats, of course, always disconnect your batteries.
Yes.
Shut your battery switch off. Because when you do get it or if you break that ignition, you don't want it stuck over in the on position. Especially
kind of like me, like leaning on the motor while you're doing it, being like, "Hey, man, how's that going?
Come on, locksmith, make it go." You're ending up in the ER. So always disconnect the battery. Step one, but just really, really light tension turning on that thing. I don't know if I've ever broken one. I've seen a lot of broke. I don't know if I've ever broken one, but it's just real, real light. You don't want to put any pressure on that. It's super thin and super cheap plastic.
Yep. Okay, well, thanks for those.
Gosh,
thanks for those pointers. I mean,
well,
I think it is. I mean, I think you're essentially saying you have to be extra careful.
Slow, just finesse.
Yes,
baby like, fingers. Just
like the goal of like sometimes, let's admit it. Like we're you know hand filing a key. You kind of get to a point where you're like, okay, I'm just gonna force this sucker over.
Right? I mean, gotta go.
Yeah, you're just like,
I've got to be close.
Boats or plastic ignitions are. One of the exceptions to that rule, right? You just want to give it just a little bit of pressure.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. Go up and down. Look for your marks. You got to be patient.
Yeah.
Because when you get to the spot where you have a broken ignition, that's not a good place to be. Yeah. Right? That's just not a good place to be. You don't want to be there.
Yeah, what do you want to do? You know, you tell the people the whole family's on the dock waiting for you. You broke the ignition. They all have their swimsuits on with their tubes ready to go, and now you broke the ignition.
Yep.
That's a bad story. Or you're in a sinking boat. I've been in a sinking boat trying to make the ignition.
You have?
Yeah, and it was like a CG1 double-sided old antique ignition.
How'd you do that?
They were in the back of the boat drinking their Coronas and bailing it out because they forgot to put the plug in it. And, of course, they drove it across the lake and then started taking on the water, lost the keys off the dock. The pump, bilge pump wouldn't kick on. So there was that was the make it go locksmith and, thing. Make it go locksmith, 4th of July. Oh, they were all
and
fresh.
How hard were you turning that one?
Man, they had two sets of pliers on that thing. Turning it, saying it's got to be close.
But did Kidlock save the day?
Got it going. Yeah.
You did?
Got it going. See, that's the only CG1 key.
Oh, my gosh.
And those are like 10 wafer or 15 wafer.
Yes.
Those are tricky. And I don't know if it was right, but it turned. it worked really smooth when I was done.
That is good. Okay. So, hey, we're looking in. Before I forget here, so they're asking, so do you use a pippin or a round file? So you like them fine, but do you like the pippin or you like the round?
Pippin.
Pippin. Okay.
Pippin. Now.
And do you have a reason for that?
No. See, my technology, I don't know if I use a pippin or not. It just, my file comes to a point. If that's a pippin.
Yeah, that's essentially a pippin.
I call the round a chainsaw file. And the pippin is just to a point, and the tip is very, very important. Not to break, don't use it as a detent push-in tool.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, pippin, because it has that real fine tip on it where if you're doing a Y11 or something small, you don't want a real wide, you don't want to space it out, and next thing you know, you have two cuts in one space. And
yep. Yeah, I think that kind of answers it. I mean, pippin's the way. I mean, I think you can do it with the round.
Yeah.
You just got to stay up close to the tip.
Stay up very close.
Right? You want to start, if you start getting halfway through that file on a Y11,
you're going 8 inches all the way on that thing. I wish I could answer these questions better.
Yeah, so there's a few new names in here for you. Kid Bad.
Kid Bad.
And there's one up here.
We haven't done the van video yet.
Yes.
Oh, working on that.
So
that's going to be a surprise.
Oh, I can't find the other one on here at the moment.
William C., he said your nickname is Master Impression.
Master of Impression.
Master of Impression. I like it.
That
I
one's
like
good. It. That
I
one's
like
good.
I like it.
I don't know if I can ever kick the Kid Lock. I mean, I've been calling you what, for almost 20 years?
Yeah, I'll let that one go. You can keep
okay,
the
I
Kid
keep.
Lock.
I mean, you know, you'll be 70 years old to be like, hey, what's up, Kid Lock?
Hey, not bad. Not bad, just going on a call.
Yes. All right, now, guys, so for everyone tuning in, I mean, quite a bit since the last time I've mentioned it, I just want to let you guys know, this Thursday, 2 days from now, 5:10 Pacific, we're going to be doing another locksmithing live Q&A. We'll have a panel of locksmiths. You guys shoot us your questions, and we're going to get some answers. How did you like that?
Delicious. I'm going to burp.
You want another? You want another one?
No, I will explode with bubbles.
Oh, man, guys. So, hey, everyone's coming in here. You guys like their beanies. Tanner, you said you liked your beanie.
Love it. Kept my head all warm all day. Yeah.
It's a good one. I mean, I've been wearing mine at night on my walks. So
in shorts and a t-shirt?
In shorts and a t-shirt.
Wow.
Oh, man, that's good. Hey, Randy Downs, how's it going? Ismail, how are you? Jay Flake. Hey, Gumby. Nice to see you on here. Starry Lock, Sherelle, all sorts, guys. So cool, guys. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. We're going to get to the winners here, the five winners in just a few moments. But I have a couple things I want to bring up. One, like Tanner just alluded to, I did a walkthrough of Kid Lock's van.
Oh, man.
Right?
Super excited. Gives me goosebumps.
In-depth. It does give you goosebumps, right?
Yeah.
In-depth look into Kid Lock's actual van. He kept it real. He showed you the way he does things, how he has it set up. How long have you been locksmithing for?
A little over 20 years.
Yeah. A little over 20 years.
Yeah.
So you're getting someone who's been literally in the trenches, on the job, every day.
Lock bossing.
Lock bossing.
Yeah. Bach Boston.
This is the first van I got set up on my own.
Yeah.
So I'm proud of it.
Yeah, you're proud of it. And guys, he's a little nervous that you guys are going to go hard on him. But yeah. I said, hey, you know what? Lock bosses out there aren't going to go hard on a guy for setting up the van the way he wants it.
Yeah, yeah, I won't take offense. I know if they're lock bosses, they're out there working in the trenches also. And good job.
Yep. So Tanner, so I want to do a little something that I haven't prepped you for.
Okay.
Yeah. So you know nothing about this, okay?
Okay.
And let's see how we go here. So, would you mind if I borrowed your wedding ring?
Yeah.
Now, just for, you know, because of the times we live in, don't take offense to this disinfecting wipe here, right?
Absolutely.
But you don't want me touching your germs, you know, or me, my germs on your hand, okay?
Okay.
So I'm just going to take it out. Now, examine it. Make sure I didn't do anything weird now.
It's clean.
It's clean.
Thanks. That's the first time it's been clean in a long time.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, it's still your ring, right?
Yeah, that's it.
So is what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this ring, okay?
Awesome.
And I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna put it in my hand here. Okay. Now I'm gonna give you my keys. Okay. I'm gonna give you my keys.
Okay.
In its place, because I don't want you to think anything's weird going on. Okay.
There's a lot of weird stuff going on.
So here. Go ahead, put your hand out and close it. Just close it. Close your hand.
Okay.
Okay. Now go ahead and take a look here. Watch this. It's gone. It's gone.
Ooh.
Want to go and look in your hand here? There's your ring.
Amazing. Yeah, you're getting good.
Hold it up so we can see.
Too bad.
You're getting good.
Right, now, guys, watch this. I want to show you a little something on this key ring. So the reason I'm doing this is a special key ring. You know, how many times, Tanner, have you been sitting at the job, you know, at the front counter, someone needs help putting their key rings on, right? Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, you're busting fingernails. Guys, watch this. Ready? That's how you need to be putting keys on. That's how you need to be putting keys on.
You're dropping the floor in the shower.
Right, now let me go ahead here and get this thing off.
Wow. I like it. Love magic.
There we go.
I love it.
There we go. Hey, guys, that's another good one from Mark Call Alakazam.
I love it. That was awesome. Awesome, Mark.
Like that?
That was cool. I love magic. Right in front of you too. That's kind of cool. Really cool.
Oh man, yes, magic trick, guys. Hey, Mark. Once again, thanks for sending those to me. So Mark had sent me from Alakazam. He's on here on live.
Yeah.
Also a locksmith. He sent me a bunch of key magic tricks.
That's awesome.
I've been loving them.
They're cool.
I mean, my execution on some of them. I apologize to anyone who considers them a. Magician. But hey, I'm trying.
I love the dollar bill with your dad.
Did you?
Yeah, super cool. Love it.
That's good. Now, guys, coming up this Friday, okay, I've been talking about this tool for a long time.
You've heard me? It's not me.
Yeah. Right? And you've seen the tool.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, guys, they're finally here. They're finally in stock. And the video is finally going live this Friday.
Nice.
So I've been pumping this one up. I mean, what are people gonna think, Tanner? You've seen it. I mean, are they gonna like this tool? Really?
Blow your mind.
Okay, well this Friday, guys, it's going live.
Yeah. Do I have one?
No, I don't have one.
Well, we just got them in stock.
Oh, okay.
So I think I can make it happen, right? So that's going live this Friday, and I highly, highly, highly encourage you to tune in next Tuesday. Can you only imagine why? Can you only imagine why I'm asking next Tuesday? It's going to be worth your time for signing in or for tuning in. So, finally, PJ, give us a hint, he says.
Give him a little tinsy bit.
Do you have any way to give him a hint without spoiling it?
No.
I'm just excited they're here. I'm excited the video's going live. And I'm even more excited for next Tuesday because... You can only imagine what I have in mind.
It's going to be awesome. Everything's awesome that PJ does.
So thanks.
It's going to be cool. Just tune in. That's all I'm saying.
I think it's going to be worth it. And I'm actually going to even have a special guest.
Oh, magician?
Like? No. No, I'm going to have one of my kids. One of my kids. Because there's a special reason for it.
Does her name start with an A?
Yes, it does start with an A.
Oh!
But all my kids' names start with an A. So.
Oh my gosh, good stuff.
Guys, hey, first of all, I want to thank everyone. If I haven't shouted out your name recently, everybody, thank you so much for tuning in right now. We're about to get ready to the 5 winners this week. Thank you all for commenting into us, emailing into us about your prizes and saying thank you. Hey, it's really our pleasure. We love doing this here because this deal, guys like you, like Tanner, all the lock bosses out there working hard every day, just like you. I mean, you're on, I mean, you haven't got any calls right now, but it's raining outside and you could be out there doing, making keys for a car, rekeying a building. And this is our way of letting you guys know how awesome you guys are.
Awesome.
So,
I saw that 72 Porsche to go unlock.
Yeah, 72 Porsche, right? Yeah. So, yeah, guys, so I'm excited. Next Tuesday, it's going to be awesome. This Friday, that video is finally going to go live. Awesome. I've been waiting and waiting and waiting, and Connor every week's like, PJ, are those tools here yet? Not yet. It's going to be worth the wait, guys. It's going to be worth the wait.
Pretty exciting. Pretty exciting.
So, without further ado, let's do the winners. That sound good?
Yeah. I tried to download a drum roll app.
Oh, you tried to?
Yeah.
I think we can just pound the table. All right. Now, guys, before I get going here, I got to hide this, right? Ooh. Everyone likes to peek.
Yeah.
Remember, this Tuesday, Locksmith Q&A live 5:10 this Thursday. We'll put some announcements out in a link. Hopefully the link will work this time. I'll do my best. But thanks again for everybody for tuning in. But without further ado, you know, I always like to pause it. You know, right, as soon as I get ready to, I like to pause it out a little bit, tease it out a little bit. Now remember, let's go over the ground rules real quick. Make sure we're all on the same page. Every week we do a hashtag LockBoss giveaway. On our YouTube videos, comment on them and include the hashtag LockBoss. Thank you guys for commenting and adding extras. Right? You've been reading them.
Love it.
Adding extras, adding little tips and stuff here. And if you can just imagine, a new locks boss stumbles upon that video. They watch it. They look at the comments. You guys are helping. You guys are being part of the solution out there for people. And I think that's awesome.
That's, yeah.
So thank you for doing that. Now, so every week, Monday through Sunday, comment. We're going to pick 5 winners. Every week we pick 5 winners and we announce them here live the following Tuesday, okay? So we're gonna make sure your hashtag LockBoss on those winners. It's completely random, and we're here to hook you up. So here we go. Drum roll, please. Winner number one is 63 Flight. Now, for the winners, 63 Flight, congratulations, and make sure all the winners email us at sales@clksupplies.com or call us at 800-848-6989. We just want to confirm your shipping address and send you your prize, okay? We'll also comment on the actual comment that we have chosen.
Prizes.
Here we go. 63 Flight. All right.
Another free prize.
Winner number two, Wes Gillen.
All right,
is that how you say that? Wes Gillen?
Yeah.
Wes, congratulations.
Oh, God. Awesome.
Congratulations. All right. Winner number three is Noah Smith. Congratulations, Noah. Yeah, a little clap.
Congratulations.
All right. Here we go. Winner number four is James Estep. Congrats, James.
All right. Free stuff.
And the last winner, but not least, is David Turner. Congratulations, David.
All right,
David. All right, guys. So those are our 5 winners this week. Make sure that you contact us, sales@clksupplies.com, or call us at 800-848-6989. We'll make sure we get those addresses correct. Get those prizes out to you guys. Thank you everybody for tuning in. Make sure you're commenting throughout the week, including hashtag LockBoss. We have a lot of stuff coming up this next week, right? The video coming out this Friday.
It's gonna be exciting, yeah.
We have next Tuesday's live. I mean,
Something special's going on.
Always.
Something special's going on.
Always in the life of CLK Supplies. It's always.
Right. We always have something going.
It's awesome.
And then here in the next couple weeks, Kid Locke's van.
Oh. Oh. Gives me goosebumps. Every time you say it, it gives me goosebumps.
That's awesome, man.
It's my baby. It's
good stuff, guys. So, hey, thank you, everyone, for tuning in. Tanner, thanks for coming on.
Thanks. Congratulations, winners.
And hope to see everybody in 2 days, this Thursday, 5:10 Pacific. We'll see you then. Thanks.
Hashtag Lock Boss.
Hashtag Lock Boss.